Mirror, mirror in my hand, who's the fairest in the land? Not you, sister. Hi, guys. San Francisco was great. Thank you so much for covering for me. Jagger and I figured everything out. We really did. We figured out that our marriage needs a toe tag. Do not resuscitate.
I paid Dr. Klein a small fortune and you throw it all away on a number two pencil.
Well, what did I do to deserve this?
Just lucky, I guess. Here, try this. Sugar-free. Oh, I used to get at least a smile for one of those.
I used to be 12.
Yeah, but you still got the same look. Joe versus the universe. Okay, who's done my boy wrong this time?
Ma.
My guess is lack of sleep or someone of a fair sex.
Fair. That's a good one.
I think there's something wrong with the water back at the house. Frank seems to be suffering from the same malady.
You're right. I didn't announce that my father's a world-famous surgeon. I mean, I didn't take out an ad in the General Hospital newsletter to announce my net worth. And hey, I didn't go online to discuss my brother's death. Because I don't want to think about it, much less talk about it.
I can understand that.
Then tell me where I violated the Scanlon Code of Ethics.
You could have said your family was off limits.
Oh, you'd have understood that?
Yes, maybe. Okay, I try. But instead of telling me to can the questions, it was full disclosure, the make-believe siblings, good old dad, the plumber, camping, taking his little brood to mass.
I've apologized every way I know how.
It makes a guy think. I mean, anybody who would lie about something as basic as who she is, she'll pretty much lie about anything.
That's your snap diagnosis? And pathological?
Well, if you're not, you're a darn quick study. You should look into changing your amateur status because you're a natural.
I never meant for that to happen.
You say you didn't have anything to hide. So what, lying is a hobby?
When I started using the name Julie Morris, I did it for professional reasons. Then you came along, asked questions, made assumptions.
About what percentage of what you say now is the truth?
All of it.
And I'm supposed to believe that? That all your life you had a secret desire to be poor? You were what, envious? Of saving 8 cents of every dime you sweat for, of watching your folks sacrifice everything just so maybe you can go to college? You wanted the feeling of being terrified to tell your folks you had this crazy dream of being a doctor? So you can all sit around the kitchen table with a pencil and a pad and figure if you all picked up extra shifts and went without again, had less again, that maybe, just maybe, one member of the family could make it through? Boy, I guess I'd lie too, because waking up to Jeeves asking the young miss which would be the lucky med school, that must have been a real downer.
That is just exactly why I didn't want anyone to know who I was. I knew what everyone would think of Julie Devlin. First class to Port Charles. Dabbling in medicine because an MRS looked so pretty with an MD on my engraved social stationery. Exactly what you thought when you got that article in the mail.
Well, you didn't trust me enough to tell me the truth.
Oh, everybody has preconceived notions about Julie Devlin. Or they want something from her. She doesn't trust people easily. I wanted to tell you.
Yeah, right.
Everything just got out of control, took on a life of its own. Hasn't that ever happened to you?
There was a woman, looked great in a towel. I put a roof over her head. She put my jump shot to shame. She's smart. I could tell her anything. She made me laugh. One thing led to another, and I was sure that she was just about the warmest, friendliest, most honest woman that I'd ever met.
And now?
Being wrong is a rare joy. You feel like a fool and it hurts like hell.
Well, well, well. Good morning, ladies.
Oh, Mike.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Mike Corbett.
Grace.
Welcome.
Thank you.
So, is breakfast on Ms. Scanlon this morning?
Oh, don't tell me you took him at poker.
Mike, you've got to stop letting me win like that. I mean, it's very flattering, but people will talk.
Well, not if people don't mention it. So, how'd you like to give a guy a chance at winning some of that money back?
Who says the man doesn't have a sense of humor?
Well, listen, I've got a temporary bartender today, so I've got to do a little supervising. Hey, welcome. Don't be a stranger.
Okay.
Hey, Joe. What'll it be, Doc?
About an OJ and a number 7. What, gave me away?
Never hurts to know the clientele.
Joe Scanlon.
Wally. Yes, sir. Don't tell me. Looks like you guys went straight from junior high to med school. Bet it takes all of you to fix a broken head. Right or wrong?
You're a funny guy.
Whoa, hello. Familiar face at 6 o'clock here. I knew this little angel of mercy at Sonny's Paradise Club. Except back then, she wasn't an angel and she had no mercy.
You want to try to bust your head?
Easy, Joe.
What? What'd I say?
You said too much, Walter. Why don't you take Joe's order and go back into the kitchen, okay?
Fine.
All right. Listen, just get comfy, pal. I wouldn't want Mary to think anything is wrong here, okay?
When did you start hiring brain donors?
I didn't, and he won't be back after today. And I hear that you are the house genius, a regular Bobby Fischer.
Maybe later.
Listen, I wasn't part of the picture back then. But I hear that Sonny gave some bad advice to Karen at a bad time. She was just a kid. And it's no excuse, but Sonny knows what he did. But look at her now. Dr. Wexler, leaving her past behind.
I don't know how she did it.
Tell you something, if more people had Karen's courage, this would be a great world to call home. Your move.
I'm calling long distance from San Francisco. Okay. Hi, yeah. Can you just tell Dr. Burgess that I will be there as planned? Okay. All right. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.
Scotty had your arrival time wrong. I mean, we thought you would do back tonight.
Yeah, I was. That smells good.
Oh, my casserole surprise. Well, surprise.
I guess you got the key from Alice, huh?
Uh-huh. With your late flight, I thought you'd be hungry, you know, and wouldn't want to cook.
Yeah, real food instead of takeout. That's a change.
Well, luckily, your grandmother, Moonlight, says, Donna Reed.
You must be wondering.
Well, just because I wonder doesn't mean you have to explain, but unless you think it might help.
Explain to you as my grandmother? Or my former psychiatrist.
Your choice.
No more choices. I want you... I don't know even what I want anymore.
Well, when was the last time you did?
On a plane ride to San Francisco.
And what happened?
Well, I'll tell you. It seems you're not the only surprise visitor I've had in the past couple days. I was waiting in my apartment, our apartment, Jagger's and mine. Waiting for him to come home so I could surprise him. And guess who pops in the door with her own key? Good old Fran.
Who's Fran?
She's been Jagger's partner for the past several years. And we were all friends.
But it seems that she and Jagger like each other best now. It's okay. She started accusing me of using Jagger and then neglecting him, and she made me doubt every choice I have made in my life in the past several years.
Well, Karen, what did Jagger have to say about all this?
He is so knee-deep in some important investigation. He can't even pick up a phone.
Oh, Karen, I'm so sorry.
I'm gonna be fine, you know? I will be. I'll be fine. I just need to have some alone time, think about everything, you know, get back to center.
Yes, I don't doubt that you will.
I don't want this to be made public knowledge.
So you're going to pretend that your marriage is fine?
I have to speak to him eventually, don't I? I mean, you know, he has to connect with me to at least figure out who gets the CDs and who gets the tapes, right? You know?
Well, yes, I would think so.
I mean, and until then, and until I can think of him without crying, I really, please, don't want anyone coming by with sympathy and pity pie.
Yes, but sometimes, you know, that can be very comforting.
I'm coming to Charles. I came here to work.
And keeping this secret, as big as it is going to make your life easier? Karen, sweetheart, if your marriage is over, then that's
what you marriage have to... is not over. Not until Jagger says it is. And until then, I don't know, maybe we can get some time alone together, you know, somehow just overcome our obligations and
Karen,
all of our
Karen,
work.
Karen, that is just fantasy thinking, and that is not good for you.
I can do this.
You can survive a breakup, yes, but you cannot repair this marriage single-handedly. You have family here. Let us help you.
I don't want my mom to know, okay? I can't bear her to tell me I told you so.
Karen, you lived with a buried secret before, and the results were disastrous.
I'm not that scared little kid anymore.
You know, I don't think I meet many people that don't have a frightened little child inside them somewhere.
Please. Be my grandmother, not my psychiatrist, okay?
Sweetheart, if you think that your grandma's advice is different from Dr. Baldwin's, I'm afraid you're out of luck.
Mike, that stuff you were saying before about Karen getting on with her life after Sonny, I bet she had to fight like hell to do that.
Yeah, that's what I hear.
I mean, she starts a new life, she goes through med school, and she comes back home. And there's Cooper waiting to bring her back down. I mean, he told a room full of strangers everything.
And from what I hear, she handled herself pretty well, considering.
And here she is, a day later, smiling like nothing happened. She was always like that.
Well, you guys are under a lot of stress.
Yeah, and poor Karen's getting it in spades. And along with these insane hours that we work and being tossed in the deep end, she's juggling a long-distance marriage, and genius boy that I am, I go and... With all that stress, I mean, the last thing you need is somebody adding to it.
Yeah, I guess so.